إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد، تبرسيد. We were going to continue with the book of the Usul al-Thalath, the three fundamental principles in the Islam by the Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, and the explanation by the Shaykh al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah. And from time to time, we're going to add, actually we're reading the book. That book, it has Arabic text and the translated to English by the Sheikh. The translation of the explanation of Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, which is from the Dar al-Hidayah. Dar al-Hidayah published. So we're gonna, because I see many of you, alhamdulillah, has that book, so we're gonna read from this book. And from time to time, as I said, for the important points, we're gonna express whatever Sheikh Fawzan, حفظه الله, he added, not Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen added here. And as we do every time, we started with the quick revision for the previous class. And that revision through the questions and answer. And even the sisters at the back, highly recommended to try to answer the questions. Before, as we said, what we have covered until now from the book, two sections, two traces. The first section, it has four matters. So this is from the first and the second class. We're not gonna go deep in there, but just we're gonna ask one question from there. What are the four matters the Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he mentioned, we have to know. We have to have knowledge about them, and we act. What's these four matters? Yes, افضل.
العلم, العمل, الدعوة, والصبر.
Yes, العلم والعمل والدعوة إلى العلم and الصبر على الأذى فيه. In English now, please.
Knowledge, and action, and calling to Allah, and patience upon the harms. When we call to Allah.
So we say it is seeking knowledge, acting upon that knowledge, which is very important point. We say we can start acting or worshipping unless we have knowledge to that point. Then calling to Allah Azza wa Jal, whatever we learn it. And as we know, all whoever calling to Allah Azza wa Jal, among them the Anbiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alayhi wa salatu wa salam, they faced harm. They got harm in for calling to Allah Azza wa Jal. Now, Uncle Ahmed, what's the proof of that? Short surah, we always reading in the salah.
إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ
وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. جزاك الله خير. والعصر. عبيدة. What's the translation of that surah al-Asr?
والعصر. By time. Verily, mankind is in
loss.
Is in loss.
Yes.
Except the الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except for those who believe.
So this is the very the proof what we the Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad Wahhab he saying for the format. We've finished that now. Let us move to the second section. The second section, what the author he said, how many matters now we have to know, have to signal. What's that, Abu Sa'id? Put the mic, please. Yes, because this is, they need to listen to the answer.
So there's three matters that is obligatory upon every Muslim.
So that he just said three.
Yes.
Now listen. What he said, it is obligatory.
The first, it is obligatory upon every Muslim, male and female.
Okay, now he said the first word in that section, what we he started with the word I'lam. What's the translation?
No.
That's me seek knowledge. And this is that knowledge, it is not optional. I mean, if you are, it is not just for interest of interest. No. Obligatory. Wajib. Obligatory. What we said about the wajib? We said the legislation in the Islam, they are five. Sheikh Al-Fawzan, he mentioned three and we add two. What does the wajib mean?
Wajib is obligatory.
Obligatory.
You must do it without doing it. You're committing a sin and when you do it, you gain reward.
Yes. The second one? What's that, Abu Sa'id? Second one?
Sunnah.
Mustahab.
Mustahab.
Yes. In English? Recommended.
Recommended, yes.
What's the recommended? Whoever he done it?
Whoever does it, he gets a reward. If he doesn't do it, there's no sin upon him.
Mustahab or mubah. The third one, mubah, which is permissible. We say the permissible, if you do it, there's no reward for it. If you leave it, there is no, you will not gonna punish it for it. The dislike, makruh. And the fifth one, let us forbidden. Forbidden, this is the danger one. If someone does it, he will get punishment for it. If he avoid it, he leave it. That's what Allah ordered us. That means he rewarded for it. Now we move to these 3 points. We covered the first point. Is there anyone who memorizes the first point? We said, firstly, إِنَّ اللَّهَ. Yes.
أَنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَنَا وَرَزَقْنَا وَلَمْ يَتْرُكْنَا هَمَلًا
بَلْ أَرْسَلَ
إِلَيْنَا رَسُولًا فَمَنْ أَتَاهُ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةَ وَمَنْ أَسَاهُ دَخَلَ النَّارَ.
Yes. So, the first point, read it in English. Abu Sa'id, now tell them what's the base in that. Because we try to
finish.
Go to 22 in this edition, yes? Let us open to 22 quickly. Everyone, whoever has the book, go to 22. No, it is not 22, Abu Sa'id. Your edition, 22. My edition, it is not 22. My edition, see? It is. Yeah. Yes, from here. This is 50 in my. What's in your book, Iqtar? The page for I'lam rahimukallah.
It's a different. It's a different publisher. Okay. Dar Salaam. Yeah.
Yeah. What Dar Salaam? What's the page? Yes, we need to know because some sisters they have Dar Salaam.
Okay.
Uncle, maybe 50. Uncle Ahmed.
Number 37. Number
37. Yeah. 37. Yeah, I know. See, but still. Because the edition, this is the first edition. 50, yes. So here, in the first one, the Imam, we covered that last week, he said, I'lam rahimukallahu innahu yajib ala kulli muslim wa muslima. That means female and female. It is obligatory on them to know, to learn, to seek knowledge for the three matters and acting upon it, upon that knowledge. الأولى إن الله إن الله خلق إن الله خلقنا ورزقنا ولم يتركنا هملا بل أرسل إلينا رسولا فمن أطاعه دخل الجنة ومن عصاه دخل النار. Yes, up to here. We covered that point up to here. So now, can you start reading it in English?
The first is that Allah created
us. No, first you say, no, may Allah have mercy upon you.
No, may Allah have mercy upon you.
This is page 50.
That it is obligatory upon every Muslim, male and female, to learn and act upon the following three matters. The first, that Allah created us and provided sustenance for us, and He did not leave us without a purpose. Rather, He sent a messenger to us. So whoever obeys Him will enter paradise, and whoever rejects and disobeys Him will enter the fire.
And finish the first one. But the dalil qawluhu ta'ala, and the proof.
And the proof. Is
this is the page 60. The page 60. The proof and the proof.
The proof is the saying of the Most High. We send a messenger to you, O people, as a witness in favor of you or against you on the day of resurrection, just as we sent a messenger to Pharaoh. But the Pharaoh denied and rejected the messenger, so we seized him with a severe punishment. Surah Al-Muzammil, verse 16.
Yes. Now, the questions to cover this section, and we move for a new point now. What he said here, Allah created us, Allah provides, sustains for us rizq for a purpose. What's the purpose? What's the purpose? Yes.
Yes.
What's the akhira?
To obey the Rasul.
Yes.
And to wahad Allahu to.
Yes. This is the first point. To. Only worship Allah, make tawheed, oneness of Allah Azza wa Jal. Then to obey the Rasul. And how we can worship Allah and make the tawheed? Through the message delivered, the message of Allah delivered by the Prophet. So now the second question, what's the purpose of the Prophet? Three points, the Shahratami mentioned them. Who knows them? Abdullah, do you know why Allah sent the messenger and the last one, Muhammad? To pass his knowledge, to teach people the knowledge of Deen. But there is one before that. Shahidan alaykum. Abu Sa'id, what means Shahidan alaykum? Allah created us, so He sent the messenger, Shahar Tamim, He said, in the day of judgment, all the creation, the human being, I mean, the mankind and the jinn. This is the message for two, by the way. The mankind and the jinn. What? Why? So there is no excuse to anyone. He said, Allah didn't. You didn't send any warner or messenger to explain to us. This is hujjah, evidence. This is what's the main question in English again? It is not evidence and proof. Something more.
Proof. It's established upon the people now.
Yes.
They have no excuse.
They have no excuse. This is the point one. So he shahid, and he will get to be witness in the day of judgment. If anyone, he said, no, I didn't receive the message, the prophets, they were going to say, no, we delivered the message, but you rejected or you refused. This is the point one. Second, to teach people, as Uncle Ahmed said, tawheed. The tawheed, the oneness, the right aqeedah. So this is, and what's the proof? We just read it. Ubaidah, what's the proof? Inna arsalna ilaykum rasoola. شاهدًا عليكم كما أرسلنا إلى فرعون رسولا فأخذناه أخذا وبيلا. Read it in English again.
We sent a messenger to you, O people.
Who is that messenger?
Muhammad.
Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The last messenger. Yes.
We sent a messenger to you, O people, as a witness in favor of you or against you.
Yes.
On the day of resurrection. Just as we sent a messenger to the Pharaoh, but the Pharaoh denied and rejected the messenger, so we seized him with a severe punishment.
Okay, now, the last question to this section we covered. What's the final result who obey the Prophet? What he said about it is, what's the final result who obey the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Brothers, the Jannah. And who disobeyed? The fire. Now, we're gonna move to the second point. الثانية, secondly, you will read them. You know what is it? The second, yeah? Stay there. الثانية, إن الله لا يرضى أن يشرك معه أحد من في عبادته. لا ملك مقرب ولا نبي مرسل. والدليل قوله تعالى, وأن المساجد لله فلا تدعو مع الله أحدا. So this is This is the love. This is the second point. Read the method first. Read the original. The second. Now we're going to follow the second in page 61. Now we're going to start covering the new section.
The second, Allah is not pleased that anyone should be made a sharer in worship along with him, neither any angel brought near, or any prophet sent as a messenger. And the proof is the saying of Allah the Most High. And the places of worship are for Allah alone, so do not invoke anyone along with Allah. Surah Al-Jin, verse 18.
Now, that the second point is connected to the first point. And the third is connected to the second and the first. The three points is connected to each other. We have to understand that. What we say in the first point, we say Allah created us for a purpose. The purpose to worship Him in the right way, as He ordered us, sincerely, and purify Him from anything. So the second point, it becomes logically what He's saying. He's saying Allah not pleasing with anyone not following the order and the message of the Prophet when he commits shirk with others. Now we're gonna move. So this is the first notes. Allah, as I said, the second point connected to the first point, as Allah created us for purpose, that is worship, worship Him alone, not participate anyone with Him. Allah not pleasing for the people who they still claiming they are Muslim, or they are claiming they witness, they testify there is no God except Allah, but they commit shirk, they participate others beside to Him. Now we're gonna read the explanation of Shaykh Al-Athaymi rahmatullahi alayhi. Read now in 20 seconds. The second
matter which it is obligatory upon us to know is that Allah, the one free of all imperfections and the Most High, is not pleased that anyone should be given a share of worship besides Him. Rather, He alone is the one deserving and having the right to all worship. And the proof is the same of Allah, the Most High, mentioned by the author. May Allah have mercy upon him.
وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحْدًا. Which the translation?
And the places of worship are for Allah alone, so do not invoke anyone along with Allah. Surah Al-Jin, verse 18. Allah the Most High forbade that a person should invoke anyone along with Allah. And Allah does not forbid anything except that it is something which He, the Most Perfect and Most High, is not pleased with. Allah the Mighty and Majestic says,
إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم ولا يرضى لعباده الكفر وإن تشكروا يرضه لكم. سورة الزمر. Yes,
if you disbelieve, then Allah is not in any need of you, and He is not pleased with disbelief for His slaves. And if you are thankful, believing in Allah and being obedient to Him, then He is pleased with that for you.
Now, what we back? We said Allah is not pleased with the one or His slave who commit shirk or who worship Him beside Allah. This is the most famous evidence. Like Surah Al-Asr, what we talked before. This is the second most famous evidence we should every student of knowledge know. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. This is one. And there is another very famous evidence. What's that? وَمَا خَلَقْتُ
وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا
لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Yes. What's the translation of it?
We did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship the Lord.
Yes. Now here, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ. The masajid. What's the masajid? The mosques. It is a plural. Now, this is not from Sheikh Al-Athaymi. This is from Sheikh Salah Fawzan. Put some dots here. The masajid, it is a plural. The singular, masjid. Then Sheikh Al-Athaymi, he say, Sheikh Fawzan, حفظ الله, he say, the masjid is the place Where? Worshipping Allah and doing the prayer. This is the first point. And he said, these masajid, this is the summary. He Sheikh Al-Fawzan, he explained that ayah with big paragraph. But we give the quick summary here, then we continue inshallah. He said, and the masajid, some of the ulama and mufassirin, they say the masajid, which is the places, or the mosques, the places where we do the ibadah. Ibadah, two types. Ibadah, two types. Ibadah, which is dua, supplication, and the dua, ibadah, worshiping, which is prayer. Yes. And he said, Allah, he said, فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Allah here emphasis and forbidding in these places, don't call beside Allah anyone except Allah. Except Allah. So this is here the word تَدْعُوا, that is mean general worship, as we said, supplications and worshiping, and any kind of worship. And this is just purely, sincerely for Allah Azza wa Jal. So we need two points. When we say فَلَا تَدْعُوا, that is mean don't call or worship anyone except Allah alone, don't invoke anyone alone with Allah, that is mean sincerity and purify that ibadah. And definitely follow as Allah Azza wa Jal commanded and his prophet. Mutaba. So this is here he said, and Shaykh Al-Fawzan saying the masajid, which is has shirk and has some innovations, he said this is obligatory upon Muslim to purify them from these aspects, purify these places from the shirk and from any innovation, any kind of innovations. It is obligatory, he said, to purify these places. Second, from that ayah from the Shaykh Al-Fawzan, what he said as well. He said, Shaykh Al-Fawzan, hafidhullah, he said, these building the masajid for worshipping Abdullah. He opened the Bible chapter after him. There is one sister outside, go. Help her to open the door for him. Show her from where the sisters can go. Go, go, quick, run. Tell her from her. Sorry about that. So, the theory, he said, building the masajid is where it is one of the great worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. So, you should. You should put pure, sincere attention. It is just for calling Allah Azza wa Jal. This is the point. Second point, building this masajid should be from something good, طيب. Allah لا يقبل إلا طيب. Allah هو طيب لا يقبل طيب. Good and pure. Pure and good. Yes. So that is the masajid. This is the second point. The third point, he said, the masajid, it has in shirk, it has in innovation. And we can change it. If someone be there, it maybe corrupted him as well. It will gonna affect him, these places. Why these places become danger? It corrupted others and propagate the shirk and innovation. For that, this is very dangerous. And that as well show how much the message from this ayah is important. إِنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Now, another, we continue with that one. Keep
Surah At-Tawbah, verse 96, Allah says, but if you are pleased with them, then still Allah is not
with
pleased
them. With who? With unbelief and kufr.
Yes.
Yes. Continue.
Allah is not pleased with those. Allah is not pleased with unbelief, kufr, in direction,
فإن طردوا عنه نار the sheikh he gives approval فإن طردوا عنه فإن الله لا يرضى عن القوم الفاسقين.
But if you are pleased with them, then Allah, then still Allah is not pleased with those who rebel against obedience to Allah and His Messenger.
Yes.
Surah Al-Tawbah, verse 96.
Allah.
Allah is not pleased with unbelief or kufr and direction of worship to any besides Him. Shirk. Rather, He sent the messengers and sent down the revealed books for war to be waged upon kufr and shirk. And so that they should be annihilated. Allah the Most High says, so fight them until there remains no worship of anything besides Allah, and obedience and worship are purely for Allah. Surah Al-Anfal.
وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةٌ وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ. Now, Surah Al-Anfal. Now here. What the Shaykh said, he said Allah not pleased with kufr and shirk. Is there any difference between kufr and shirk?
Yes.
Yes, Ayub. Good boy. Good answer. Jazakallah khair. So, what's the difference? Who knows what's... Alaykum salatullah. Who knows the difference between kufr and shirk? What's the kufr? What's the shirk? Uncle Ahmed, do you know?
Kufr is not believing.
That's what to Allah said. Yes.
And shirk is making ibadah or worship to other than Allah.
Besides Allah. Jazakallah khair. Yes, this is the answer. So this is very important. Kufr. Who they completely, totally, they don't, they disbelieve in Allah. What they call it in English?
Disbelief. No, or unbelief.
Atheists.
Yes. And shirk, what's the shirk? The people of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all is what they named him in the Quran, washirkeen. What does it mean? Shaykh al-Fawzan, he said, they believe in Allah. They don't say there is no God. They believe in Allah. They believe in Allah. But they worship idols, and other things, they say, we worship them just as intermediary to make us close to Allah Azza wa Jal. And so that, they're claiming, they believe in Allah, but they do this, that not make them believers. They not believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. For that, this is really dangerous. So, the masajid, Shaykh al-Fawzan said, back to this ayah. He said, the masajid, the places where purely, sincerely, just calling and praying and worshipping Allah. Making salah, making dua, everything. He said, the other masajid, which has graves, or calling al-Hasan, calling al-Husayn, calling Abdul Qadir, whoever, that's that Shaykh al-Fawzan saying, they're corrupted their belief, their faith, and that lead to they are not Muslim. Even if they clearly they testify Allah one God and Muhammad is messenger. Even if they claiming that not enough for them. So this is really dangerous. For that the author Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab رحمه الله big that ayah it has meaning إن المساجد لله فلا تدعوا مع الله أحدا. So now we're gonna ask next class what's the difference between kufr and mushrikeen. Yes. Continue.
Since Allah is not pleased with kufr and shirk, it is obligatory that the believer is also not pleased with them.
What we say here when we hear a word obligatory, wajib. What does it mean? We have to. We have no options. This is order commanded from Allah Azza wa Jal. So that we not pleasing with the kufr, it is wajib. And what the ulama they say from the condition of La ilaha illallah, we say one of them, you love and that word and you believe it and must disbelieve other God is that beside to Allah Azza wa Jal. Must have to. So this is here again. It is to please with them. It is obligatory for us not pleasing them with them. Because why? What's the reason? Allah Azza wa Jal not pleasing with them. And whatever the believer, whatever Allah not pleasing with it, the believer is not pleasing with it. Whatever Allah Azza wa Jal loves, the believers loves.
This is because the believers loving and hating must conform to what Allah loves and hates, so that He is angry with that which angers Allah and is pleased with that which pleases Allah, the Mighty and Majestic. So since Allah is not pleased with kufr and shirk.
See, Shaykh Al-Athaymeen, how he put all of these words, kufr and shirk. So we're not just talking about the kufr, we're talking about the shirk as well. So the section of people who they claiming la ilaha Allah, but they commit, they do wrong things, they commit shirk. Continue.
Since Allah is not pleased with kufr and shirk, then it is not fitting that the Muslim should be pleased with them. Then shirk is something very serious and dangerous, as Allah the Mighty and Majestic says, indeed Allah does not forgive associating anything in worship with Him, but He forgives whatever is lesser than shirk to whomever He pleases. Surah Al-Nisa.
The ayah in Arabic, we have to hear the kalam Allah Azza wa Jalla, the speech of Allah, the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah Azza wa Jalla say, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Yes, continue. Now, the other, now Shaykh Al-Athaymeen, as we said, the methodology of the Shaykh Al-Athaymeen, in the explanation, he always explain the author words, then always he supported with the evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah, and also the evidence from the intellection, the intellect. And also sometimes he provide and support by normal examples to make it clear what he's saying. Now, the other ayah, so he still now give evidence that the shirk is very dangerous. Not just the kufr, the shirk, very dangerous. What he saying, the second evidence or the proof from the Quran, the textual proof, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكِ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. Read it in English, which the meaning is?
Indeed, whoever associates anything in worship with Allah, then Allah has forbidden paradise for him, and his abode will be the fire. And for the wrongdoers who worship others besides Allah, there is none to aid and save them on the day of resurrection.
Now, also he will give evidence from the Sunnah. As we said, Shaykh Al-Athaymeen, we have two kinds of proofs always. Textual proofs, which is from the Kitab and Sunnah, Quran and the Prophet, and intellectual proofs. So now, the other proof from the Sunnah, what's the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in English?
The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Whoever meets Allah not worshipping anything along with Him will enter paradise. And whoever meets Allah having worshipping others along with Him will enter the fire. Rewarded by Muslim. Read it again, Abdul Qadir, quickly.
Whoever meets Allah not worshipping
anything
Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever meets Allah not worshipping anything along with Him will enter paradise, and whoever meets Him having worshipped others along with Him will enter the fire. Sahih Muslim.
Yes. Now we're going to start. We have another 10 minutes. We start with the third point as well. الثالثة أن من أطاع الرسول ووحد الله لا يجوز له موالاة من حاد الله ورسوله ولو كان أقرب قريب. والدليل قوله تعالى. We'll just read this one first, then we'll go to the evidence. Read the third. Now this is the third matter. Yes.
The third matter. That whoever is obedient to the messenger and singles out Allah with all worship upon Tawheed, then it is not permissible for him to have friendship and alliance with those who oppose Allah and his messenger, even if they are those most closely related to him. And the proof is in the saying of Allah the Most High.
Wait. So now we said the three matters connected to each other. The first one, the first matter, why Allah created us, the purpose to worship Him alone, sincerely purify Him, purify all our worship, and all worship acting to what Allah ordered and commanded and His Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And in the first point as well, the purpose of the sending the messengers and the Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the purpose, why Allah sent him. The second one, if we know the purpose of us, it is worship Allah alone and purify our faith and aqeedah and make sincere before Allah Azza wa Jal, so that Allah is not pleased with someone who loves and the kufr and he commits shirk and the kufr. And this is the connected to that. If Allah not pleased with the kufr and the shirk, that is mean. Whoever obeys Allah and he worshiping, and this is the second point, and that third point, it will gonna be Allah. He does not like to make alliance and friendship whoever to disobey him and make kufr and opposites their him. Continue now in the translation. The third point will come to this one.
The third matter, which is obligatory for us to know.
This is not from the Sheikh Muhammad Wahab. This is the Sheikh Al-Faydani,
rahimahullah. Sheikh Al-Faydani, rahimahullah. He explained that the third matter, which is obligatory for us to know, is that of alliance and disassociation.
Yes, it is.
Al-Wala wal-Bara.
So this is what they called it in the Sharia, Al-Wala wal-Bara. So this is alliance and dissociation. Al-Wala. Sheikh Salah al-Fawzan, he defined the Al-Wala three points. One, loving by heart. Second, aiding and helping. The third, inherit and paying the wrong blood when someone kills someone by mistake. So there are three. Now we're gonna come what mean these three. Loving by heart. What's mean Dalwala? Alliance. That is me, Sheikh Al-Fawzan, Hafidullah, in summary in this part, what he's saying. He's saying the Muslim, the believers, they can't make alliance and friendship except to believers, to the Muslims. So this is the wala alliance. That how it can be happening through three. Loves them by heart, sincerely. So love is by heart, the wali. So to fulfill the word of the wala, the alliance. Love all the believers by heart. Second, aiding them, helping them when they need, wherever they are, west and west, if they are believers. Uphold the Quran and the Sunnah. You have to aid them when they need and helping them. The third, inherit and paying the payment of the wrong blood. When if someone killed another one by mistake, car accident, something, you pay the diya. You pay the money that for the family who they lost the debt. So this is the wala. And this one, it is very important matter. This one in the Sharia. It is very important, especially for those live in non-Muslim country. They face a lot of challenge and testing to fulfill that al-wala and al-bara. Continue. Sheikh Al-Faymin said,
alliance where the believers obedient to Allah and His Messenger, and enmity and disassociation from the unbelievers and those opposing Allah and His Messenger.
So this is the definition given by Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen. It is same, almost same. So Allah is, it's me, as the Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen say, with the believers. It is a kind of worship. It is not a kind. It is one. It is one of the worshiping of Allah Azza wa Jal. Okay, now we see the worship in the first hadith. We have three kinds of worship: some by heart, some outwardly, some action. So this one, it has the wala by heart as well. The first starting by heart, or it is something connected to the heart. The loves and the hate is connected to the heart, and by action, as we said, with aiding them, helping them, all the other matters. Continue.
So this alliance and disassociation is a great principle emphasized in many texts.
So here I put two lines under a great principle. It is one of the great principles. It is very important that al-wala'u wal-bara. Al-wala'u wal-bara. It is one of the great principles. Allah is. قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا بطانة من دونكم لا يكونكم خبالا.
O you who believe, do not take as friends and protectors those outside your religion, since they will not spare any effort in trying to corrupt you.
This is the same what Sheikh Al-Fawzan حفظ الله say. He brings this ayah or this proof from the Kitab and Sunnah. What we gonna happen, Allah Azza wa Jalla say? What we gonna happen? They will not spare any effort in trying to corrupting you. This is the danger. This is the danger. For that, how they say, for that, he's saying, Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen, it is a great principle. Yes. And the other one, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَكُمْ هُزُوًا وَلَعْبًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَالْكُفَّارَ أَوْلِيَاءَ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ.
O you who believe, do not take as friends and protectors those who take your religion as mockery and fun from amongst those who receive the scripture before you, nor from the idolaters, and fear Allah concerning this if you are truly believers.
Now the other ayah, أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا آباءكم وأزواجكم أولياء إن استحبوا الكفر على الإيمان ومن يتولهم منكم فأولئك هم الظالمون. قل إن كان آباءكم وأبناءكم وأخوانكم وأزواجكم وعشيرتكم وأموال اقترفتموها وتجارة تخشون كسادها ومساكن ترضونها أحب إليكم من الله ورسوله وجهاد في سبيله فتربصوا حتى يأتي الله بأمره والله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين. سورة التوبة.
O you believe, do not take as friends and protectors your fathers and your brothers if they choose unbelief to believe.
Shaykh Al-Fawzan, he is saying, even whom they are closest to you, which they are your fathers, sons, brothers, close friends.
And whoever of you takes them as friends and protectors is one of the transgressors.
Yes.
Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to those who choose to remain in the land of the idolaters and not to emigrate to the land of Islam, if your fathers, your sons, your brothers, your wives, your families, the wealth which you have earned, the trade which you fear you will lose, and homes which please you are dearer to you than Allah and His Messenger and fighting jihad in His cause, then wait until Allah brings about His decree, the conquest of Mecca, to see the retribution that awaits you, and Allah does not guide the disobedient. Surah At-Tawbah 23 and 24.
Now the other woman is saying, قد كانت لكم أسوة حسنة في إبراهيم والذين معه إذ قالوا لقومهم إنا براء منكم ومما تعبدون من دون الله كفرنا بكم وبدا بيننا وبينكم العداوة والبغضاء أبدا حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده.
You will not find a people who believe in Allah on the last day. There is a fine example for you to follow in Ibrahim and those with him when they said to their unbelieving people, "We are free of you and whatever idols you worship besides Allah, and we deny and reject what you are upon. And because of your disbelief in Allah and your worship of others besides Him, enmity and hatred has arisen between us forever. Unless you believe truly in Allah and single Him out and worship Him alone."
Surah Al-Mutah. Now, the Shaykh Al-Athaymeen, he will give a quick, logical summary for that, which is everyone, he can't reject it if he think logically about it, which is that this is because
having friendship and alliance with and seeking to please one who opposes Allah is a proof that the belief in Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his heart is indeed weak.
So this is why the Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen, he said this is danger, and that is why he said al-wala wal-bara, it is very important principle, because this is a proof your level of iman. This is a proof your the level of the loving of Allah Azza wa Jalla and His Prophet.
This is because it is against reason that a person can have love for anything that is an enemy of the one he truly loves. Alliance with the unbelievers means to help and assist them in their unbelief and misguidance which they are upon. And having love for them is shown by doing those things which will earn their love and friendship by any means. Without a doubt, this shows that true belief, iman, is either totally absent or is at least deficient.
This is very dangerous, and this is same for the kuffar and the mushrikeen who they worshipping Allah and worshipping other things beside Him. Continue.
Rather, the believer must be in a state of enmity with those who oppose Allah and His Messenger, even if the person is the closest of relations to him. He must have hatred for him and separate from him, but this does not prevent him from sincerely advising him and calling him to the truth.
The last thing we finish by it, just 5 lines. The author, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Wahhab, radiallahu anhu, he gives a proof from that, from the Quran. He said, "La tajidu qawman yu'minuna billahi wal yawmi al-akhir yu'minuna man hadda Allah wa rasulah walau kanu aba'ahum aw abna'ahum aw ikhwanahum aw 'ashiratahum ulaika kataba fi qulubihim al-iman wa ayyadahum bi ruhin min wa yadkhuluhum jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhar khalidina fiha radiyallahu anhum wa radu 'anhu ulaika hizbullah ala inna hizballah hum al-muflihun."
You will not find the people who believe in Allah on the last day loving those who oppose Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even if they are their fathers or their sons or their brothers or their kinsfolk. Rather, Allah has decreed true faith for their hearts and strengthened them with proof, light and guidance from Him. And He will enter them into the gardens of paradise. Beneath those trees, rivers will flow, and they will dwell therein forever. Allah is pleased with them, and they are with Him. They are the party of Allah. Indeed, the party of Allah are the successful.
May Allah make us all of us among His party.
Ameen.
We're going to finish up to here today. Then we're going to start a new section. Which is again, I want to start with no, but I conclude that in very quick reminder for myself and for everyone here. Jazakumullah khairan. As we live here in this country, we saw a lot of shirk and kufr as well. And as you know, we are very close to the end of the year, which is it's gonna be very soon. We're gonna see the Christmas and these parties and this stuff. So this is required of me and for everyone. Why the ulama sunnah, the scholars of the sunnah, they say don't participate in these festivals or Eids or parties. Why? They said it is very dangerous because it's showing your level, your faith level. Because if you participate in this or congratulate them or saying or just passing some words to them, that means you supporting or you congratulate them for their shirk, which is the most high danger thing and most seen. You can do it. For that, it is just reminding to us and as a benefit from what we seek in knowledge today. Al-wala wal-bara, alliance and disassociation with others. This is one of the kind of that, the ulama they say. We should show them we are not agree with that. And gently we pass message because you believing Allah has son. And we believe Allah Azza wa Jal, the high, the majestic, he is one. He is just one and nothing similar to him. So for that, the ulama sunnah, they say this is very dangerous. And this is just as a reminder from myself, and just I put, وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَنْفَعْنَا بِمَا تَعَلَّمْنَا وَيَجْعَلْنَا نَعْمَلُ بِمَا تَعَلَّمْنَا وَيَجْعَلُهُ خَالِصًا لِوَجْهِهِ. So may Allah benefit us from the knowledge that we seek, and may us acting upon it. It is very important, sincerely, purely. And we make dawah to others as well. جزاكم الله خير. Now I'll be سعيد when we conclude this.
Jazakallahu khairan for everyone attending, coming out, and benefiting from the dars. Just to recap what our brother Ahmad was speaking about. Obligatory to have knowledge upon three matters, and that is that Allah created us, provided sustenance for us, and He did not leave us without a purpose. Rather, He sent a messenger to us, so whoever obeys Him will enter the paradise, whoever rejects and disobeys will enter the fire. Second, Allah is not pleased that anyone should be made a sharer in worship along with Him, neither any angel brought near, nor any prophet sent as a messenger, and the proof is in the saying of Allah, and the places of worship are for Allah alone, so don't invoke anything along with Allah. Surah Jinn. And three, whoever is obedient to the messenger and singles out Allah with all worship upon Tawheed, then it is not permissible for him to have friendship and alliance with those who oppose Allah and His messenger, even if they are the most closely related to Him. So, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq.
We were going to have a question as well next, about the second and the third month. Before we start with the Hanafi,
inshallah. Again, we thank everyone for coming out. We see some new faces as well, alhamdulillah. And after the lesson is concluded, we're going to pray Salat al-Isha, inshallah, and then we'll have some light refreshments. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.